Zach Fisher, 2021, brought 10 games, which takes his total career games to 73. And unfortunately, it was the story of another interrupted season. It's the second year in a row now where he's had a significant chunk of time away from the game through injury. And it's tough. Like, you know, what do you say? Are these things preventable? I'm not sure. Is it a load thing? Is it just a thing that's just unlucky? Who knows? Is it a positional thing? I'm a big fan. He's one of my favorite players. I don't hide that. Got a massive bias towards him. I just think he's got all the tools and he's got the right mentality. We saw that in 2020 where he accepted that role as the small forward, even though that's probably not his natural position, and you know, accepted it glowingly and worked on it and did whatever the team needed. And I think that was a big sign of maturity last year. I mean, I remember doing the season review for him last year and talking about that. This year started off nicely, and then unfortunately in the, you know, the Collingwood game, he hurt himself and we didn't see him until later on in the season. And I feel like we moved away a little bit from him as a small forward, which for me personally, I love. I am of the firm belief this guy is a midfielder. He can, you know, maybe play spurts in the forward line. And I kind of understand why you'd want to have him forward of center, because he's so creative. He's got this, I refer to it as like the fast twitch fibers in his brain, but really it's just his reaction time. He's just quick with his thinking and he can get himself out of situations that not many players in the competition can. He's just really, he's really nimble and quick, and his dexterity is there. But just unfortunately, we just, you know, I can't even imagine what it's like to play in this league. You know, when you miss two or three games, let alone, you know, the amount that he missed in a row, and then having to come back and train, and then, you know, the rest of the competition has played the whole time. So it's difficult. It's difficult to, you know, to talk about, because it's happening to a lot of our players, and that's where the frustration comes from. Because, you know, it's seemingly every week we get one that's unavailable. But I mean, moving forward, I just want to see him in open space. I think when he's got time to assess his options, he makes the right decision. I think he can execute by foot. He can kick it long enough. He can kick it short. He's also good in traffic when we're, you know, handballing the ball around in congestion, and he's very much a good link in the chain. That's how I watch him play. And he's got this, it's like this infectious energy about him. Like we're a more energetic team when he's around the ball, and we're a more energetic ball moving team when he's around the ball. And that's why I want to see him. I'm not sure if it's more of an inside role. The way I look at it right now, maybe something on the wing. There's no reason why he can't have a solid preseason, build up the tank and play on the wing. I know that we've got Lachie O'Brien there on that left side. I don't see why Zach Fisher couldn't do that. I think we want to get the ball in his hands more. He still averaged just a tick under 16 possessions a game in 2021, which shows that his ability to win the ball is always there. He's dangerous. I just don't think right now, or maybe not just yet, he's ready to kick, you know, 25, 30 goals as a small forward. I'm not sure. The way I look at it, I'm looking at how do we play him to his strengths. So ultimately, who knows? The coaches will come in, they'll put a plan around him and they'll make the decision. We'll just sit here and watch it and hope for the best. He's a really good human, good clubman. He's good with the fans. That's always been something that sticks out from me. I think one of the things that we spoke about this year on the channel with Luke Power, and you know, he spoke about there's a notion of who you are off the field doesn't necessarily have to be who you are on the field. And I think that's probably one area where I'd like to see a player like Zach evolve in that, you know, be a little bit more forceful on the field, a little bit more angry, a little bit more of a hunter on the field. There was some criticism, you know, later in the year about his tackling, but you know, he had a game where he didn't lay a tackle, but then he responded the week after with 7 and then 5 the week after. So as long as, I feel like anything above 3 to 4 tackles a game, you're doing the right thing. I think if you're a midfielder or if you're a pressure player, you probably want to be hovering around that, you know, 4 to 5. Now it's easy to say and it's hard to do, but I think that's where the next layer of evolution comes. First and foremost, got to get a healthy year, got to have an injury uninterrupted year. We can't afford to have players like him who are really starting to come into their own in their careers, and there's just too many of them that are missing chunks of football in these formative years of their career. But at the end of the day, we're getting to a point where, you know, Tachlis, it's time. It's time to, you know, make your mark. And I'm in full faith that he's going to do that. So I'm excited for what Vossi will do with him. I think he's a player that any coach would love to have on their team and love to coach because he's so selfless. And, you know, hope for the best, hope for health. That's the main thing for me in the off-season as we move into it right now in the preseason for 2022. But what about you? How did you see the year? Was it just another case of unlucky? And where do you think we can get the best out of Zach moving forward? Is it forward of center? Is it in the midfield? Is it on the wing? Is it a combination of both? Let's have a chat about it in the comments.